हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम वैभव शर्मा, प्रेजेंटली वर्किंग एज असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग इन एबीएस इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज गाजियाबाद। टुडे वी आर हेयर टू डिस्कस अ टॉपिक वेपर कंप्रेशन रेफ्रिजरेशन सिस्टम। आफ्टर सीइंग द टॉपिक फर्स्ट कम्स इन आवर माइंड दैट व्हाट इज रेफ्रिजरेशन। द रेफ्रिजरेशन इज अ प्रोसेस इन विच वी मूव हीट फ्रॉम वन लोकेशन टू अनदर लोकेशन within the controlled conditions. As we know from the second law of thermodynamics, the Clausius statement states that it is impossible for a self-acting machine to raise the temperature of a lower temperature body towards the higher temperature body without the help of an external work. So by the use of the second law, we are doing the refrigeration here, vapor compression refrigeration system. There are four basic components of the system. The four important components are compressor, condenser, expansion valve and evaporator. The compressor is a device where we are providing the work. The compressor can be further classified into many terms, such as centrifugal compressor, reciprocating compressor, rotary compressor, and screw compressor. The home appliances like refrigerator we are using at home, air conditioners we are using at buildings at homes, we are using reciprocating type of compressor in that. Reciprocating can be furtherly classified The reciprocating compressor can be furtherly classified as hermetically sealed compressor, semi-hermetically sealed compressor and open tank. The applications of this system we are used in refrigerators we are using at home, the air conditioners, centralized air conditioners, deep freezers in which we use ice cream and cold storages such as. So after compression that comes next condenser. Let us give the name 1 to 2 as compressor and 2 to 3 as condenser. So condenser is a device which is used to condense the refrigerant traveling in this cycle from vapor state towards liquid state. The refrigerant vapor start compressing in the compressor and after that the pressure of the vapor rises. The state is also vapor here after the end of compression. Then this vapor refrigerant goes inside the condenser and after the condenser the stage of refrigerant is liquid, since the condenser condenses the vapor refrigerant coming out from the compressor. The condenser we are used in the home appliances is air conditioner. The condensers can be further classified as air condensers, water condensers, but in home appliances we use air condensers. Then this liquid effluent passes through the expansion valve and we get cooling over here. There are many types of expansion valve. We are having different types of expansion valves, such as capillary tube, hand operated expansion valve, thermostatic expansion valve. The use of individual expansion valve is as per their need. In the home appliances system, we use capillary tube as a expansion valve. Then after the expansion valve, the condition of the refrigerant is liquid refrigerant. This liquid refrigerant travels from the evaporator. It absorbs the heat from the surroundings and make the surroundings cool. The temperature of the liquid refrigerant when passing from the evaporator rises and it converted into vapor, and the cycle repeats itself. The evaporator is a device where we absorb the heat from the surroundings. In home appliances like refrigerator and air conditioners, we use we are having a fridge at home. The freezer which is placed in the fridge is the evaporator. As we take the example of air conditioner, the cooling coils which are there in AC are the examples of evaporator. Now let us see this vapor compression refrigerant system on PV, HS, PH and TS diagram. As we take 1 to 2 compressor here, so we are showing the process 1 to 2 as compression. Then we take 2 to 3 as condenser, we show here 2 to 3 as condenser, 3 to 4 expansion valve, 3 to 4 expansion valve, and 4 to 1 evaporator, the 4 to 1 is evaporator. Before starting this cycle, we are having some assumptions. Assumptions are, the compression process should be isentropic. Second assumption, the condenser and the condensing should be isobaric, that means at constant pressure. The expansion or throttling process should be isenthalpic. And last, the evaporation should be isobaric. After taking these assumptions, we have plotted this VCRS on a PH diagram. Here 1 to 2 is compressor, 2 to 3 is condenser, 3 to 4 expansion valve, and 4 to 1 evaporator. Now One more thing, the throttling process is a process in which the entropy change is not equal to zero. There means there is some entropy change. Now, let us see this VCRS on a TS diagram. Compression, condenser, expansion valve and evaporator. Let us discuss this VCRS on a HS diagram. In all the three cycles, we can see that when we compress a refrigerant in a compressor, the pressure increases. In PS diagram, we can see that the pressure increases. The enthalpy also increases. In TS diagram, we can show the properties. When the compression takes place, the temperature increases, the entropy remains constant, as we take in assumptions that compression should be isentropic. Next, in HS diagram, we can see that the isentropic compression takes place. The isentropic compression takes place and the enthalpy increases. Then in condenser, from 2 to 3, the enthalpy decreases and entropy also decreases. From 3 to 4, since the enthalpy is constant, we are showing here enthalpy is constant, the entropy is increased. And from 4 to 1, we are evaporator, the enthalpy increases and also the entropy. Also, we can show this diagram on PV cycle. 1 to 2 compression, 2 to 3 condenser, 3 to 4 expansion valve, 4 to 1 evaporator. So we can study all the properties of this VCRS on these 4 cycles: PH, TS, HS and PV. Now, why we are doing all this? We are doing all this for calculating the refrigerating effect produced in the VCRS. What is refrigerating effect? Refrigerating effect is the cooling effect generated in the evaporator. Here we can see that in diagram the refrigerating effect is in evaporator from 4 to 1, since we are getting cooling effect in the evaporator. I repeat once more cycle. In compressor, at the entry of compressor, the vapor is at the refrigerant is at vapor state. After compression, the stage is also vapor there. Since it is the property of a chart that this is saturated liquid line, this is saturated vapor line, and further this line, if we extend this line, here is the superheated region. So at the start of the compressor, the refrigerant is in vapor state, and at the end of compression, the refrigerant is at superheated state. Now after condenser, this refrigerant vapor which is in superheated state changes to in the liquid refrigerant. This liquid refrigerant is further expand in the expansion valve and converts into liquid refrigerant, but the temperature reduces. This liquid refrigerant passes through the evaporator, takes the heat from the surroundings and converted into vapor refrigerant and leaving the effect that the surrounding should be cooled. So refrigerant effect we are getting in the evaporator. By the first law of thermodynamics, if m is the mass of refrigerant flowing in the VCRS, then m into H1 minus H4. This is the net refrigerating effect. If we want to calculate the work done in the cycle, the work done is from 1 to 2 in the compressor. As we have discussed already, that according to second law of thermodynamics, it is impossible for a self-acting machine to raise the temperature of a lower temperature body to the higher temperature body or moving the heating effect from one place to another place without the help of an external work. So we are getting work done in the compressor. Again, if the m is the mass flowing as in the cycle, so from 1 to 2 is compressor, so m into H2 minus H1 is the net work done. So if we want to calculate the COP of the cycle, coefficient of performance, it is desired effect per unit work done. So desired effect is refrigerating effect here. Since we use this formula of COP for heat pump also, but we are talking about the refrigeration here. So desired effect is MH1 minus H4 upon MH2 minus H1. So net COP is H1 minus H4 upon H2 minus H1. If we want to calculate the mass flow rate, as we go to the market and we have seen that on the shops of air conditioners, there are air conditioners of 1 ton capacity, 2 ton capacity, 3 ton capacity. What is that? As we go to the shops, we are having different types of air conditioners. We say 1 ton capacity, 2 ton capacity. We have said on the shop that we want a AC of requirement 1 ton, 2 ton, 3 ton. Then what is that ton? That ton is basically the power consumption of that air conditioner. If we talk about 1 ton of refrigeration, 1 TR is equal to the refrigerating effect produced by melting of 1 ton of ice from and at 0 degree Celsius in 24 hours. From this formula, we can calculate the value of 1 TR. That means 1 ton of refrigeration is equal to 336, that is latent heat of fusion of ice into 1000, converted ton into kg, upon 24 kilojoule per hour. If we calculate this, it comes 14,000 kilojoule per hour. If we talk about the unit 1 ton, that is equal to 0.9 ton. So what is the use of this ton? Let us go to a shop and told him to give a AC of 2 ton capacity. So net capacity is 2 ton. We convert it into 14,000 kilojoule per hour. This is equal to net refrigerating effect. Produced by the VCRS. So, if we are having the enthalpies from pH chart of different refrigerants, H1 and H4, then we can calculate the mass flow rate of the refrigerant as per our need. Suppose we have to buy a AC of 5 ton, then we can change this value of 2 as 5 and we can calculate the mass flow rate as per 5 ton capacity. The only thing we have left in this discussion is about the refrigerants. There are many types of refrigerants such as hydrocarbons, halocarbons, azeotropes and so on. But if we talk about the practical refrigerant we are using nowadays in refrigeration or air conditioning is R134a. In early time we are using ammonia as a refrigerant, but due to its toxicity it is replaced by another refrigerant, and then we have different types of chlorine atoms in that refrigerants which is harmful for our ozone layer. Then we have reduced these chlorines from the refrigerants, and now we are going on research for finding out the best refrigerants which are having good effects on ozone layer and which are non-toxic, non-inflammable and so on. The properties on which we find out the refrigerant are thermal properties, physical properties, chemical properties, and some other properties such as easily available, cheap, so on. So by taking these few points in mind, we can choose our refrigerant as per our cycle. So application of this VCRS is, I repeat, in home refrigerators, second, air conditioners, third, deep freezers, which is used to place ice creams, water coolers, used to cool the water, cold storage plants, central air conditioning, we used to go to movies, we used to go to malls, we are using central air conditioning system, but the process is same, vapor compression refrigerant. So these are all the practical applications of this VCRS, but we choose the refrigerants as per our need. Thank you.